What's up, family? Hope everybody is doing well. Welcome to my channel. Like, subscribe. Let's make this channel grow. Hit the notification button so you can get all this crazy, dope content. I thought, you know what? I feel like a change of scenery. I'm gonna go outside and do this in one of my favorite spots in the car park. Just a different energy, different vibe, sitting in the car, nice and relaxed, with the seatbelt on, just in case, to be safe, you know what I mean? You never know. Right, the topic of today is the upcoming heavyweight battle in Riyadh, Saudi Arabia. Let's get into it quick, baby. We don't want to be out here all day long. It's against, I've got my notes here, Francis Ngannou against Anthony Joshua. Now, honestly, I'm really looking forward to this fight. It is going to be one hell of a barnstormer. It's going to be a great, great matchup. And to be honest with you, yesterday I watched the story of this Francis Ngannou, how he made his journey from his country of Cameroon and what he went through to come to this point. An unbelievable story. And you know what? I wish him the best. And to be honest with you, there's a part of me saying I hope he wins. But obviously, the part of me, the British side of me, is saying I want Anthony Joshua to win. So I'm a little bit conflicted. But let's look at the stats. Who could really win this heavyweight battle? But look, Ngannou is... he must be flying high. Because why? Because personally, I think he beat the fight when he fought Tyson Fury. He won that fight, to me. Now, if you're going to like look at boxing for what it is, you got the best man on the planet, Tyson Fury. Hasn't been defeated. And there's all these rumors about he ain't trained. And he says he's trained. All this nonsense. You don't know what to believe, right? And he comes into this fight, he probably wasn't motivated because he was supposed to fight someone else. And then they give him this fight, someone who's never had a boxing match. Took him lightly, probably. Probably knowing him didn't train. And got knocked down by a hook, left hook as well. Struggled to finish the fight. To me, he lost the fight. The guy doesn't understand his opponent. One of Tyson Fury's tactics is to bully the opponent with his size, to weigh on him, frame around, wear him down, because that can really wear you down. But he doesn't understand. This guy, Ngannou, is used to that in the UFC. Strong, powerful. He underestimated them, and this is what happens. Right. He's going into this fight with an extreme confidence that he can beat Anthony Joshua. And we all know that Joshua doesn't have a good chin. And that Francis can bang. And he's definitely going to go for that chin. And if you look at most of his knockouts in the UFC and the what he caught Tyson Fury, it's all punches. He's striking. And if he lands, this is a big guy, man. You know, there's a big difference. Look, Joshua's 31, he's 34. Ages are close. Let's look at the stats. 31 fights, Joshua. He's 31-34, excuse me. The fights, 25-19. Joshua's got more experience. Wins 24-16. Goes to show. But the win ratio, let's have a look. He's lost it. Yep. Draw, 0. 22 KOs, Joshua. 13 KOs, Ngannou. Joshua's 6'6", he's 6'4". Both orthodox. 82-inch reach. Ngannou's got an 83-inch reach. So he's got inch. That inch can make the big difference, right? 17 stone 3 is Joshua. And Ngannou is 18 stone 7 pound. So he outweighs him by 14 pounds. Now that's a lot. Especially when it's muscle. And that's power, man. That could make a lot. That inch and that poundage could make a lot of difference. Obviously, Joshua's from England and Ngannou's from Cameroon. This is going to be an amazing fight. Look, if it goes any way like the Tyson Fury fight, obviously, Joshua, watching that fight, he ain't going to underestimate him. But the only thing with Joshua is, the only problem that I have with Joshua, how hungry is he to prove himself? If he stays on the outside and boxes him, I don't know who could have a chance. But what used to work for Joshua? Joshua used to use a lot of combination movements, and he used to be a good finisher, right? And he changed his style. He's trying to box from the outside, trying to do all this. It doesn't work for him. Stick to what works, bro. But Ngannou is going to test him, because look, at the end of the day, he doesn't have nothing to lose, does he? Really? So he's just going to test that chin. He's going to go for the chin. The worst, nobody's, look, either you got a strong chin or you ain't. Most of the knockouts, they come from the chin anyway. And if you got a weak chin, and then you got an opponent like Ngannou, the Predator, one smack, one left, they're going to knock him out. And he can bang. And people don't understand this guy started his career as a boxer, but forced to go into MMA because of the rules that was in France that he couldn't go in for some reason. I can't remember off the top of my head. I sort of know the other day. So this is going to be an interesting fight. There's a part of me that says I want Ngannou to win. There's a part of me, obviously I'm British, I want Joshua to win. I'm a fan of both fighters. But my instinct tells me, my gut feeling tells me Ngannou's going to win by a knockout. So that's my take on the fight. Tell me what you think in the comment section, baby. So like and subscribe this video so we can make this channel grow, man. Don't forget that. That's very, very important. So I can carry on making these videos, right? Stay lucky. Stay blessed. Keep your hands up, bro. Laters.